Hello guys, welcome back to another video. I am in the same shirt from the previous video, but that's okay. I'm getting ready for work, y'all. Like I said in the last video. So this video is going to talk about, I talked about the culture, but I'm here to talk about relationships. How do you know you are in a toxified relationship? Okay, first, the sign that you're in a toxic relationship is don't ignore the warning signs. If this person has not shown you respect when they first met you, they're not gonna show you. That's one. Two, if you have to ask somebody over and over and over and over to show you, hey, you don't need to talk to me like that. Hey, you don't need to, if you gotta tell somebody over and over how to treat you and how to show you that they like you or love you, it's toxic. That's a bad relationship. Cut it off. If somebody got to sit up there every time that you say, hey, I don't like this about you, and they got to turn around and say, it's not me, it's you, that's another red flag, sis. Let it go. That person is not willing to accept they're wrong and accept that you are not being treated like you want to be treated, and they're going to continue to play the victim as long as you allow them to. So the next tip that I want to say about a toxic relationship, if you know that person is talking about your life and your life is real good versus what they got going on, like they can't help you in your life, they can't help you if you have a broken arm or if you are out here doing something that puts you in a bad place, if they can't get you out of that place, let that person go. If they gotta always talk about, well, the past, whatever that person has done to you in the past, if they gotta bring it up in your face, throw it up in your face, you don't need that relationship, sis. You don't need that energy. You don't need that toxicity, because one thing that I have learned in this life, what you can do, what you think a man can do for you, you can do for yourself 10 times over. And if you can't, grind to do so. Don't put more into a person than you will put into yourself, because at the end of the day, you gonna need you. And that man gonna do him. And that's another thing. If it's not, if we in between toxic and not being in a good committed relationship, if that person is always on their phone when they're around you, and they're not giving you all the attention, it's time to let it go. If somebody that person is engaging with that's more important, I don't care if y'all chilling, I don't care if y'all friends, I don't care what's going on. If that person is not giving you that attention that you need in the presence of them, then no, let that person go. So another thing about being in a toxic relationship, sometimes you won't be able to see the signs because you want to like this person so bad. Don't worry about liking them. Don't like them so bad that you can't see. Because you endure more hurt at the end than you will seeing the signs and recognizing and moving on in the beginning. Okay? And so I'm just here to tell you, if you're in a toxic relationship, if that person got to make you get out of your character to even explain something to them, even if they don't get it, if that person got to laugh in your face about whatever you're talking about, let it go. It ain't worth it. And that's another thing I want to talk about. People in their 20s, man, all these relationships don't have to end up in like unwanted pregnancies. For real. I'm going to just be honest. Because just because you are with this person, that don't mean that's your partner forever. You just with them for one season in your life, and you gotta acknowledge that fact that you are just here for a season. Whether that's a lesson or whether that's a blessing, you here for a season, unless that person is really genuinely care about you, is really into you, really wanna make you a long-term commitment, you're here just for a season, and you gotta treat it just like that. And I would not stop dating other people just because I'm with this one person, because I'm not saying cheat on the person. What I'm saying is, if you all are just trying to fill each other out, I would still keep that door open, because you don't know who will come by and could spark your interest. Now, if you're in a relationship, stay faithful, stay committed, don't cheat on your partner. But if you are in a toxic relationship, please get out. I ran across a video one time of a young lady that I knew, very personal, and her boyfriend was beating on her. Y'all, if your partner is beating on you, leaving marks on you, Whether you are the girl, whether he is the guy, whoever leaving the marks need to go. It need to be cut off because that means that it's getting out of hand. You all got to put hands on each other and cuss each other out. Also, verbal abuse. Don't let nobody verbally abuse you. People be like, oh, he just mad right now. Don't accept it. Because when somebody can verbally abuse you, somebody can physically abuse you, and you will cover it up. So don't accept it. Once you notice it the first time, leave. Because it's not going to get better, it's going to get worse, and it's going to drain you. It really is. It's going to drain you a lot, and you don't want that in your life. I don't care how old you are, how young you are. If a man is putting his hands on you, threatening your life, taking you through toxicity, you don't need it. Also about numbers, I have a bad habit of blocking and unblocking, but I'm here to tell you, block that man number, and if you don't like blocking, delete the whole number and move on, or change your number. I'm in like a situation where I don't want to change my number, but I'm gonna have to fess up and change it one day, sis, because it's not, you know, either it's up to me to let it go and move on forward, or it's up to me to keep entertaining it. And like I said, I'm here to tell y'all, block the number, move on, let it go. Like, that's it. But, I mean, as I said, I see a lot of young people that are just out here, oh, I'm with so-and-so for 5-6 months, end up having an unwanted pregnancy, it has to be with this person for the rest of their life. And then when the thing happens, like where you have to stay with this person forever and ever and ever, raise this child, and may become toxic. You don't know because of what, you know, has transpired. Everything happens so quick, you don't know them. So what I'm saying is, get to know somebody first. Because that's all I'm seeing on my timeline, is that a lot of people in their like younger 20s are having babies, and they don't really know the person, and they're now stuck with the person due to the fact that they had a baby with them. So what I'm saying is, know your partner. If you do see any warning signs, like, don't ignore it. Get out the relationship and move on, because sis, you have life to live. You are a beautiful person. Even if I don't know you, you're still beautiful. You're beautiful in your own way. And so I'm here to tell you, keep God first, stay blessed, and if you see any warning signs of a toxic relationship or a relationship you need to end, please end it, and y'all stay safe. This is Faithfully Blessed, and I thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Bye-bye, guys.